Right, we are also joined by Javed Ansari. And Javed Ansari, we were just discussing with Aarti about how Pranab Mukherjee is somebody who's been in politics for so many years, decades, five decades. You've also interacted with him, since you've also had this long career in journalism. If you could share some memories or any sort of interactions that come to mind at this point.
Well, there's so many of them. The one that comes to mind, you know, Aarti was talking of his famous temper. It was like a soda water bottle. He used to erupt immediately and subside even quicker. There have been so many occasions. I remember the day before he was to take oath as president, he was giving interviews at his Talkatora residence, and we were all slotted 3 minutes, 4 minutes each. I'd been covering the Congress party, so I developed a fairly good equation with him. And so when the interview started, I said, sir, 3 minutes will not be enough. He says, okay, let's start. And we started, and it went on for 12 minutes. And by the end of it, his secretary and his staff were willing to tear their hair out. But we continued. And towards the end, I said, sir, we will miss you, and now you'll be out of reach. He said, Javed, I am not going to Mars. I'm only going to Rajpati Bhavan. And I will miss the viewers. I used to work for BBC Hindi service in London in 2005 and actually interviewed him for BBC radio in Hindi. And you can imagine, Pranab Mukherjee used to struggle with his Hindi, but nonetheless, he obliged me. All my colleagues in the bureau were laughing, were falling down with laughter. And there was Pranab Mukherjee holding forth in Hindi. There's so many memories. You could call him at 2 o'clock at night, so long for information. He'd provide perspective. He'd educate you. And then, like Aarti said, my best way of dealing with him was I used to go and tell him, Dada, you need to educate us. Please educate us. I don't know enough on this. And I'd lie back and just absorb everything that he said.